Did you see my shot? Alright, sorry, I'm still trying to get a wide bevel right now. Thank you.
Okay, so what happened? If it's no one's here.
Yeah. I changed this quickly.
Huh?
Changed this quickly.
Yeah, yeah.
Thank you.
Mark.
So she was on your blind side?
Thank you.
I'll just do a little bit.
You're good, man. Thank you.
You want to just look towards me?
You're good.
All right.
Ready to go.
Sorry, where do you want me looking?
Just right at me.
Good afternoon, my name is Brent Weisberg. I'm the spokesperson with the Salt Lake City Police Department. My last name is spelled W-E-I-S-B-E-R-G, first name Brent, B-R-E-N-T. At approximately 3:45 this afternoon, we received multiple 911 calls about a car into a building here at this location. Our officers immediately responded along with paramedics and firefighters, and they located a full-size SUV inside the Foot Locker store here behind me. At this time, our investigation is still ongoing, but we do know that we have four victims at this time. One of those victims has been transported up to a local hospital in critical condition. We also have a woman who was pregnant, 21 weeks at the time. She suffered minor injuries at the time of this crash. We also know that that woman actually basically picked up her child, pushed her out of the way to avoid the impact of this crash as well. So that those are the three victims. And then the driver, an 81-year-old woman, was also very minor injuries as a result of the vehicle going into the building. At this point, we are investigating this as a possible driver malfunction. When she was in the vehicle, it appears that the driver mistakenly hit the accelerator instead of the brake, causing the vehicle to go into the building behind me at this point. Because of the injuries and the nature of this crash, we have activated our crash team. They are responding, and they will conduct a full investigation. Obviously, you can see behind me as well that we have Salt Lake City Fire. They responded with their heavy rescue. Those firefighters were immediately able to get on scene to assess the structure of the building itself, and also to locate the victim who was pinned underneath the vehicle, and they were able to immediately secure the vehicle to make sure that those firefighters could then take out the victim who was trapped underneath the vehicle.
What time was the call made?
So this call came in at 3:45 this afternoon. We received multiple 911 calls about a car that had crashed into the building behind me.
When I look at that and trying to figure out how it got in there, was this just coming from a parking space? Got that much momentum, or was it coming from
there? Still part of the preliminary investigation right now. What we're trying to do is, with our crash team responding, they're going to come out here, they're going to diagram the scene, and they're going to be able to review any surveillance video that may have captured this incident. They'll also talk to witnesses and speak with the driver to determine exactly how this crash occurred.
We were just observing it doesn't seem to have affected other businesses in the area that remain open.
For the most part, all the other businesses in this area are still open at this point. It looks like maybe one or two other businesses are impacted.
As for the person that was pinned underneath the vehicle, can you give us any information on the severity of the injuries that they sustained?
So the person who was trapped underneath that vehicle has been taken to a local hospital in critical condition.
Is there any, can you identify and say it was an employee of the store?
I don't have that information at this time.
Was the child one? Yeah, as you said, the child was one of the people that was injured.
Yeah, so I can recap the injuries. Again, we have a total of four victims in this case. One of them is the 81-year-old driver. She has very minor injuries and is being treated on scene. She is cooperating with this investigation. We also have a woman who was 21 weeks pregnant at the time. She was inside the store, and when the crash occurred, she actually was able to kind of scoop her child behind her, her 7-year-old child behind her, to make sure that that child wasn't hit by this car that came into the building behind her. And then, so that child suffered minor injuries, and as well as her mother, also minor injuries. And then, of course, the person who was trapped underneath the vehicle has those critical injuries. So again, total of four victims as a result of this crash.
Just any estimate of how long the crew should be on scene?
You know, typically when we have our crash team come out, it is a several hour lengthy investigation. They have to diagram everything. So it's probably going to be at least 2 to 3 hours for them to diagram, to collect all the evidence that they need. Again, we'll have to diagram the scene, collect any surveillance video, and again, speak with any additional witnesses who may have seen anything.
Dumb question, could you re-spell your name?
Yeah, sure. First name Brent, B-R-E-N-T, last name Weisberg, W-E-I-S-B-E-R-G, and I'm spokesperson with the Salt Lake City Police Department.
Thank you.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you so much, Brent. Good.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
All right.